Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillahi wa kafa. Wa salatu wa salamu ala abdihi al-Mustafa. Wa ala alihi wa sahabatihi wa man bihadhi iqtafa. Wa sallama tasliman kathira. Amma ba'd. Alhamdulillah, we are back again to continue the risala of the Shaykh al-Allama Abdul Rahman bin Nasir al-Sa'di rahimahullahu ta'ala. May Allah have mercy upon him wa rahimahullahu jami' ulama al-Muslimin. So I believe today will be the last class inshallah ta'ala, meaning today inshallah ta'ala, or tonight inshallah ta'ala, we'll finish with this risala of Sheikh Al-Allama Abdul Rahman bin Nasir Al-Sa'di. And again, I will highly recommend my brothers and sisters in Islam to go and study this risala again, read it and reflect upon it again, and try to teach it even to your family. Because it is very beneficial risala. And to remind myself and my brothers and sisters in Islam, may Allah bless you and all of us, the title of the risala, logical proofs for the oneness and perfection of Allah Jalla Jalaluhu. So this risala, my brothers and sisters in Islam, it is very needed in our time. It's very needed in our times. Our time, the reason being because there is a lot of shubuhat, doubt and misconceptions about the existence of Allah Jalla Jalaluhu. And so this risala will help you to build foundations in believing Allah Jalla Jalaluhu. So alhamdulillah, the Shaykh, may Allah have mercy upon him, mentioned many, many ways how to prove Allah's existence. And sahih, my brothers and sisters in Islam, for example, when you think about the Nubu'at that Al-Mustafa alayhi salatu wasalam said, not just Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasalam, likewise Prophet Jesus, even in the New Testament, there is some valid prophecies that Jesus alayhi salatu wasalam mentioned. Likewise, in the Old Testament, there is some true prophecies and the valid prophecies that the prophets and the messengers in the Old Testament have mentioned, which their followers did not corrupt. Because as we have mentioned many times, miraran wa tikrara, over and over again, that we don't believe the Bible to be completely batil, completely false. We believe it contains truth thereof. So my brothers and sisters, may Allah bless you all. So when you look to the Nubu'at, I stick to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because as I always mention, that if we establish with the tangible proofs and the rational and logical proofs that Nabi alayhi sallallahu alaihi wasallam is a true prophet, then the sound logic dictate to follow him. And that which he came with, to believe in the Anbiya wa Rasul, the prophets and the messengers that came before him, alayhi salatu wasalam. So some people just reflected upon the seerah of Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, that will suffice them to know that this man must be sent and chosen by the Most High, Jalla Jalaluhu, Almighty. The magnificent. Some people just reflecting upon the prophecies of our beloved Prophet Muhammad alayhi salam, that will suffice him to accept that Nabi alayhi salam is true prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Some people just by reflecting upon al-Sharia al-Muhammadiyya, the Sharia, the legislation, the rules and the law that the Messenger came with, that will suffice him to know that what the Messenger of Allah came with is from Allah Jalaluhu, and that indicates that he's perfect, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Likewise, some people just looking at the akhlaq, the mannerism, or mannerisms, and conduct of an Nabi alayhi salatu salam, how he dealt with his families, how he dealt with his enemies, how he dealt with his friends, how he dealt with the environment, how he dealt with the animals, and other things that will suffice the person who has, who possess al-aql al-salim, likewise the fitra al-salima, or al-aql al-sarih, or fitra al-salima, that the person that possess sound reasoning and sound or pure natural inclination. That will suffice him to believe that the Messenger was a true prophet. So, likewise, some people just looking at the ayat al-kawniyya, the universal signs in the within the creation of Allah Jalla Jalaluhu, that will suffice him to know there is a creator behind this tremendous, well-designed and organized and beautiful creation, which he possess al-ilm, knowledge, perfect knowledge, and al-qudra al-kamila, and the perfect ability, likewise irada, intent and will, and mashi'a, and al-hikma al-baligha, and perfect wisdom, and also by reflecting upon other things or other aspects to that will point towards the perfection of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Sheikh Abdurrahman bin Nasir al-Sa'di, he said, well, the message before that, sorry, then he quotes Sheikh al-Islam wal-Muslimin Ahmed ibn Abd al-Halim ibn Abd al-Salam ibn Taymiyyah al-Harrani rahimahullah ta'ala, that he quotes from the speech of Sheikh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, may Allah have mercy upon him, the words of Sheikh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah about the signs of the Prophet, about the signs of the prophets. The signs of the prophets are from that which the intelligent know to be particularly for them and not for any besides them. They know Allah hasn't created their likes for other than the prophets, whether regarding their signs that happened during their lives of their people, or their signs by which Allah distinguished between their followers and their beliers, those who reject them, by saving those and destroying these. And this, like Allah did destroy the people of those who rejected the Prophet, the messengers, and Allah saved their followers. The likes of this is Allah. So he's given example where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed the enemies of the Anbiya wa Rasul, and Allah saved the followers of the Anbiya wa Rasul. Anbiya mean in Arabic, the Anbiya is Arabic terminology, which means prophets. Wa Rasul, which means messengers. So he said the likes of this is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala drowning all the people of earth except for Noah and those who were with him upon the in the ark. Nothing similar has ever happened in the world. Also is the likes of the destruction of the people of Ad or Iram with its high pillars, whose likes were not created elsewhere in the land. Now, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Alam tara kayfa fa'ala rabbuka bi'ad Iram dhati al-imad التي لم يخلق مثلها في البلاد. So have you not seen how Allah dealt with the people of Ad, which Allah Adam وثمود الذين جابوا الصخرة بالواد, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned about the people of Thamud. The Shahid, he mentions here, also is the likes of the destruction of the people of Ad, Iram, with its high pillars, whose likes were not created as were in the land, despite there were many of them, power and tremendous civilization, the likes of which had not been created as well. They were then destroyed by scorching, devastating wind unleashed upon them in continuously for 7 nights and 8 days until they became like the trunks of collapsed date palm trees, while Hud and whoever followed him were saved. So here the Sheikh Abdul Rahman bin Nasir al-Sa'di is quoting from the speech of Sheikh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah, mentioning how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed the people, those who rejected the Prophet and messengers. And this is from the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because Allah drowned the people that rejected Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam, and he saved only the those who followed him. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala nahma about Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam, likewise about Irama, which is people of Ad, and how Allah saved Hud and destroyed people of Ad. And it's never happened in history, something similar to it. Something similar to it happened in the history. When Allah will destroy, the whole nation will be destroyed, except those who follow someone. Except the prophets and messengers. So Allah showed the people. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed the people of Ad. And likewise, Allah destroyed the people of Fir'aun, and Allah saved Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. Likewise were the people of Salih, the dwellers of cities. Likewise, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved Salih and his followers and destroyed his enemies. Likewise, the people of Lut, the dwellers of multiple cities that were lifted into the sky and then sent over upon them, and then furthermore followed up by stones from the heavens to finish off anyone remaining. Lut and his family were saved, except for his wife, who was striking with her fate. The likes of this never happened elsewhere in the world. The intelligent know of these signs in general, and they are not the type of things people normally die from. Some people might get a plague, and some might get leprosy, and the likes. And this is what people are used to. It's from Allah's signs in different way, and every major occurrence is from Allah's signs. But these signs are not what are normally experienced. And subhanAllah, that is sahih. And it's from the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala aiding his anbiya wa rusul. Likewise, the people of the elephants. أَلَمْ تَرَ كَيْفَ فَعَالَ رَبُّكَ بِأَصْحَابِ الْفِيلِ. Until the end of the ayat, أصحاب الفيل, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed the people of Fil. And then it goes on to mention, so the signs of the prophets are signs and evidences of their truthfulness. Included in this is Allah's divine law regarding separating between the prophets, their followers, and those who reject them. Then he mentioned, referring to Ibn Taymiyyah, because he's not quoting Ibn Taymiyyah word for word, so he's quoting the Shaykh. Barakallahu feekum. Then Shaykh Abdul Rahman bin Sa'di said, then he mentioned verses about the destruction of the deniers of the messengers and the salvation of the messengers. Then he said, these stories were widespread and reported with impeccable plurality throughout the world. The people knew that they were signs of the prophets and the punishment of their deniers. As such, they remember them in similar situation in order to take lessons. The verses of the Quran survived throughout the lengths of time, since the time the messenger brought it. The verses of challenge have been recited along with his saying, قل إن اجتمعت الإنس والجن على أن يأتوا بمثل هذا القرآن لا يأتون بمثله ولو كان بعضهم لبعض ظهيرا. That say to them, O Muhammad, قل إن. Okay, say to them, if mankind and jinn were brought together or were together to produce the likes of this Quran, they could not produce the likes thereof, even if they helped one another. The very fact that the messenger informed of this since the beginning and was certain about it, despite his knowing the number of people, is a proof that it is supernatural. So here the Sheikh Ibn Taymiyyah is speaking about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or the Messenger of Allah coming with the ayat, which is challenge the people. So this ayat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed it, says the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Likewise, the time of Ibn Taymiyyah, and between the Prophet and the life of Ibn Taymiyyah, this verse was recited openly, and challenged the people to bring something like the Quran. And also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, قُلْ لَإِنْ اجْتَمَعَتِ الْإِنْسُ وَالْجِنُّ عَلَىٰ أَنْ يَأْتُوا بِمِثْلِ هَذَا الْقُرْآنِ لَا يَأْتُونَ بِمِثْلِهِ وَلَوْ كَانَ بَعْضُهُمْ لِبَعْضٍ ظَهِيرًا. Say, O Muhammad, if all mankind and jinnkind come together to produce something like the Quran, they will never be able to do so, even if they helped one another. Even though we know, Prophet when he was reciting these verses, the Arabs heard it, many people heard it, and his enemies, they were looking for an excuse to invalidate his prophethood, likewise invalidate his messengership, likewise his the Sharia that he came with. Then he goes on to mention, this doesn't happen for anyone other than the prophets. Then furthermore, despite the length of time in which those who agree or disagree hear it from the Arabs and non-Arabs, there has not been a book read by people amongst the nations which can be said to be like it. He's speaking about the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Na'am, this is how the scholars speak about the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The scholars refute the doubts about the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The scholars, the true scholars, spread the virtues about the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Likewise, increase the iman of the Muslims. The fake scholars, the true scholars for dollars, they are the ones who increase doubt in the people's hearts, in the hearts of the believers. The likes of Al-Fadi, may Allah save us from his misguidance, and may Allah guide him. And wal-iyadu billah, you see Muslims just defending him. And I read one passage, wallahi, I said, you know, this passage describes some Muslims perfectly. He said that some Muslims, maybe they will see the jail, and clearly he says, kafir, say, brother, don't charge him, you don't know what is in his heart. Yes, you don't know what is in his heart. Yeah, kafir billah, the jail. Somebody will defend Al-Fadi. Muslims and non-Muslims are known this man has doubt. He needs tabib. He needs to go back to the ulama. His PhD did not benefit him. Him and his PhD will go to the bin if he does not make tawbah and for the truth. Naam, the true scholars defend the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The true scholars, when you listen to them, the likes of Abdurrahman bin Nasir al-Sa'di, you increase your iman, increase your yaqeen, certainty. Likewise, the likes of Ibn Taymiyyah, Ibn Uthaymeen, the likes of Sheikh Rabi'a, read their works. Shamsi bin Abbad, Abdul Hamid bin Badis, one of the scholars of Algeria, one of the great scholars of India, Sindhi, during the life of Imam Muhammad Abdul Wahhab, rahimahu wa ta'ala, he wrote a nice book refuting the Rafida. The shahad, barakallahu fikum, increase your iman. Not this father who some Muslims keep defending him. Wa'iyadu billah. Na'udhu billah min dhalik. We are free from him. And he's free from us, alhamdulillah. We refer people to scholars. And we always will know our level, alhamdulillah, by saying, Shamsi, I'm just giving you information. I am naqil, not mufti. I don't call myself mufti, alhamdulillah. I'm someone who transmits to you the works of Ahl-Ilm. But always go back to Ahl-Ilm scholars. And I always mention, stick with those who are known for over 3 decades to be upon the correct methodologies. Go listen to them 30 years ago, same speech now. The speech of 30 years ago concerning Aqidah Manhaj, they have it now same. لم يتبدلوا بحمد الله. They have not changed by Allah's tawfiq subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. Because they humble themselves. They don't say we are in the West. We don't need scholars of Saudi. We have to deal with our issues. We are not in need of scholars. Then we start calling ourselves scholars. Because we have PhD from Yale, from Orientalist University. أعوذ بالله من الخضلاء. So the Shaykh Barakallahu Fikum, read the works of Al-Ilm. The scholars increase your iman. Not decrease your iman, wa'iyadu billah. Na'am. So the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the best book ever. The greatest miracle. And no one, they know the way that we should humiliate this ummah and control this ummah by bringing doubt about the book, the Quran. Because if we don't have Quran, we're finished. I'm telling you, khalas will be humiliated. Wal'iyadu billah. The honor is in following the book of Allah Jalla wa'ala. يَرْفَعُ اللَّهُ بِهَذَا الْكِتَابِ أَقْوَامٍ وَيَضَعُ بِهِ آخَرِينَ كما قال الفاروق أبو حفص رضي الله عنه. When he saw the Emir of Mecca, he said, who he left behind in Mecca? He said, so and so. He said, he's from the Mawali. He's a free slave. He said, na'am. He said, لكن يا أمير المؤمنين حافظ لكتاب الله. But oh, leader of the believers, he memorized the book of Allah. He was a free slave and they put him in charge. That's in the time of Abu Khattab. He was in charge over the Arabs. Why? Because he memorized the book of Allah. And he said, I heard the Messenger said, يَدَعُ اللَّهُ يَرْفَعُ اللَّهُ بِهَذَا الْكِتَابِ أَقْوَامًا وَيَدَعُ بِهِ آخَرِينَ. Allah will raise people through this book. When you implement and understand it, Allah will raise you and will debase those opposites. Allahu Akbar. The Shaykh Barakallahu Fikum, then Shaykh Islam Mutaymiyyah Rahmatu Ta'ala, Shaykh al-Islam. How dare you, you are father, you compare some al-Uda to Shaykh al-Islam Mutaymiyyah. Because you are liberal مثله. نعوذ بالله من الخذلان. The Shahid Barakallahu Fikum, أيها الأحبة في الله. Let us love the deen of Allah Jalla wa'ala more than anything else. Some people make excuses for him. I fear for these people. He will say, أنا كافر. They say, no, brother. You don't know what is in his heart. He said, no, I'm kafir, my brother. He said, no, brother, he doesn't mean it. نعوذ بالله. This person full of doubts, full of misconceptions. Non-Muslims, and I will say it again, because I see many non-Muslims are using this video when he was speaking to Muhammad without hijab of dignity and honor, slander and liar. They came together and guess Ahl-Sunnah, Allah humiliated them through that video. That live stream was humiliation, was big slap. That Christians are using it, and guess some Muslims who follow them, alhamdulillah, not us. That's what I say, this is your product. This is your product, all Christians and non-Muslims. You raised him, not us. So don't try to use it and guess us. He is not our scholar. Abadan. Never. So, oh David Wood, stop lying. Because you are, I know you're a liar. You're a deceiver. Yes, a Qadi is not our scholar. He's a scholar of those who listen to him. So when you debate them, use him. Okay, use him. But us, we believe he's Darlun Mudil, misguided person. Even my wife, she was listening with me. And she said, A'udhu Billah. She said, if some Muslims who have weak iman, they think, okay, why? Because Yasser al-Fadi, when he was talking about with Muhammad Hijab in his live stream full of humiliation, wal-iyadu billah, talking, then he says, talk about the Quran. He said, you know, the best time, we don't want to talk about it now. Why? Is that inability to hide? That's why you are indicating. If a layman Muslim are watching it, think, oh, is there any doubt about the Quran or something? Why talk about the preservation, the huruf? A'udhu billah. Openly we talk about it. The books that are talking about the Ahraf, the Quran, is being sold in our bookshops openly. We will sell them in the caves. You know, when you go to Islamic bookshop, they don't have those books under the table. No, openly, they sell them. Alhamdulillah, because nothing to hide. Alhamdulillah, nothing to hide. So don't say, the way he was speaking about it, as if there is something to hide about the book of Allah, Jalla wa Ala. A'udhu billahi min dhalik. Some Muslims try to make excuse for him. And what is worse, Muhammad Hijab, because the heat was too much on his head, he edited it. But now, yes, Al-Fadi, that's what he wants to do. He wants to spread doubt. He never edited it. He never took out that part. Now the Islamic haters, they come out. Say, look, the Muslims are not trustworthy. Look in this of Muhammad Hijab video, that part's not there. Why? Why you shave off it? But the yes, Al-Fadi, because Muhammad Hijab, he doesn't want to be doubt. He thinks, okay, I made a mistake. Now, let me remove it. But the worst thing, your colleague, who you don't want to free yourself from him, your colleague still putting it out. Because that's his aim, to spread doubt into the Muslims' hearts, wal-iyadu billah. How can you defend someone like him? I'm free from him and he's free from me, wal-iyadu billah, min dhalik. Anyone who loves the Quran and the Sunnah from Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will say openly, we are free from him and he's free from us. And there's another video of an ex-Muslim, Murtad, online, using Yas al-Qadi speech about how Islam spread. You see, if you hear him, wallahi, full of doubt. Even one guy said, this guy, I'm loving him, man. Same guy online, the video is online. He said, I'm loving this Yas al-Qadi. He's telling the truth. Wallahi, Yas al-Qadi, wallahi. وَبِاللَّهِ وَتَاللَّهِ صَاحِبُ بِدْعَةٍ وَضَلَالَةٍ وَضَالٌ مُدِلٍ. Be aware of him. This person is trumpets for the Orientalists. The enemies of Islam are using him to spread doubt against the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Muslim brothers and sisters, parents, be aware. Do not let your children to listen to this guy. This guy full of doubt. And he has not, those doubts has not been removed from his heart, because this person is mutakabbir, arrogant person. Muta'alim, pretender to be scholar, pretend to be scholar, PhD from Yale University. Wallahi, it's better for me to be jahil than to have, which Fatah Salima than PhD from Yale University. But about what? About Islam. Na'udhu billah min dhalik. Khalkhaluh. You know Khalkhaluh? Khalkhaluh, they shaked him up. He didn't know what he was doing. Na'udhu billah min dhalik. Mas Allah al-afu wal-afiyah wa-salama. The book of Allah. Yes, there is some narrations. Those narrations, some are weak. Some of them are fabricated by Zanadiqa. Some of them are being misunderstood. That's why you need to go back to scholars. Not scholars of Yale University. And alhamdulillah, don't lie against our scholars didn't give convincing answers. Yes, to you and your teachers in Yale University. And who said your teachers in Yale University our criteria, what is convincing and what is not? Who said that? We're not convinced with it. Mashallah, so what? Who said it's a condition for the truth to be the truth who said in order for something to be true, you have to be convinced? Abu Jahl, he was claiming that he was not convinced with the Messenger of Salam. That is not Delhi. You're not convinced, then khalas, the truth is the truth. May Allah bless you, brothers and sisters. Have ghira for the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For the book of Allah jalla wa ala. Yala yarfa'u Allah bihadha al-kitabi aqwaman. وَيَضَعُ بِآخَرِينَ Allah will raise people through this book and debase people that go against this book. With the Sahaba and the Tabi'een, وَأَتْبَعَ التَّابِعِينَ Hold into the book of Allah, Allah raised them. So the enemies of Islam notice that. They notice the Muslims, they will never be humiliated completely as long as this book is with them. So what we do, we need to control them completely. Let us bring doubt about this book. نَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنْ ذَلَكَ May Allah give us ikhlas, sincerity. And may Allah give us حسن الخاتمة. And نَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشُّبُهَاتِ وَالشَّهَوَاتِ Naam, so then Shaykh al-Islam goes on to say, this is known by all. There is no speech people utter, no matter how high it is. No matter how high its level in wording, meaning, except that people have said what is similar, what resembles it, or is close to it. Whether it be poetry, sermon, letters, from form or otherwise. Nothing of that sort can be found except that what resembles it or comes close to it, it can also be found. The Quran, Ar-Rahman wa'allama al-Quran. خلق الإنسان وعلمه البيان الله أكبر The Quran is known to have no comparison by all people, Arab and non-Arab, despite the eagerness of the Arabs and others to oppose it. Wallahi, I read the book of Allah. That's why I've been doing, I told the brothers, let us in our Instagram page, likewise our Facebook page, before you know, let us put the clip of recitation of Quran. We have to connect ourselves to the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you listen to Quran, يَأْخُذُكَ إِلَىٰ عَالَمْ آخَرْ Take you to different world, Allahu Akbar. The Quran, the ayat, and the ma'ani, kalimat, subhanallah. And look what he said, Ibn Taymiyyah, rahimahu wa ta'ala. Read the works of Ibn Taymiyyah. Don't listen to the Fadi. This مخذول خذله الله نعوذ بالله من ذلك نعم تواضع we have to humble ourselves that's why always I say my brothers and sisters I'm not the best person you know listen to the mashayikh the scholars listen to the student of knowledge don't listen to these clowns on YouTube you know today he buys laptop opens up channel خلاص becomes a mufti ايش هذا اللعب نعوذ بالله من ذلك The shaykh, barakallahu feekum, and this social media is more harmful than good. Why allows sufaha, foolish ones, to become mufti, to become a scholars, to give an idea, my opinion. Here's the opinion. Who's you? Like me. Me personally, I have no opinion in the deen of Allah. No, in any back. Allah said, Prophet Sallam said, Salaf said, the scholars said. That's our deen. Opinion, why am I to give opinion about deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Am I mujtahid? The shaykh barakallahu feekum. That the book of Al-Qur'an Ibn Taymiyyah, let me repeat it. Wallah, let me repeat it. This is known by all. There is no speech people utter, no matter how high its level in wordings and meaning, wording and meaning, except that people have said what is similar. Sahih. What resembles it or is close to it, whether it be poetry, sermon, letter form, or otherwise. But only comes the book of Allah abadan. Where? Which book have you read? Start like the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Maliki yawm al-deen. O maliki yawm al-deen. Iyaka na'budu wa iyaka. إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ Then it goes, this just Surah Al-Fatiha, powerful chapter. I know there's a brother I've heard a long time ago, someone informed me, someone became Muslim just because Surah Al-Fatiha. Describing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and asking what? You ask Allah for guidance, and you worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Read the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and listen to the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the Quran is known to have no comparison by all people. Its wording is a sign. Listen to this. Listen to the speech of Ibn Taymiyyah. Listen to the speech of the true scholars. They increase your iman, my brothers and sisters. May Allah bless you all. Not to the Fadi, the trumpet of the Orientalist. Its wording is a sign. Its structure is a sign. Its informing about the unseen is a sign. Its order and prohibition is a sign. Its promise and threat is a sign. Its majesty, greatness, and authority over the heart is a sign. When it is translated to other than Arabic, its meaning are signs, or it's a sign. There is no comparison in the world to it in any of that. Allahu Akbar, the Quran. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from those who always read the book of Allah or listen to the book of Allah and implement it. And implement it inwardly and outwardly. So my brothers and sisters, even translation, subhanallah. When you translation, how many people accept Islam just reading the Quran in English language? Or other translation? Like when you read, you know, the Quran, إذا صح التعبير, the stur, the stur Rabbani is like, Quran is like, you leave it. You leave it like your life. It tells you how to live your life. Everything is in there. Everything. As I've mentioned, when you listen to Quran, it takes you out from the stress and depression of the world to light and guidance and peace and tranquility. Allahu Akbar. And there's meaning to it. Allah, the Anbiya, like if you are a husband and you have a problem with your wife, the solution is the Quran. If your sister have a problem with her husband, the solution is the Quran. With your children, the solution is the Quran. With your people, the solution of the Quran. All the solutions is in the Quran. And ya ayyuhal Quraniyun, mean the Quran give us go back to the Sunnah of Nabi alayhi salatu wa salam. Like one guy said to me, I told you this one before, my brothers and sisters. Quran, I've heard Quran was not passed down by tawatur. It's not mutawatir. Quran is not mutawatir. Allah is, what can you do now? Is that like, there's some saying in my country, it's very funny about stuff like this. Like, what are we to do now? So we have, it is ma'aruf in the history that thousands of people memorize the Quran and there's no tawatur. Okay, but as I've mentioned, sometimes what the ulama do, they will mention those who are famous. Like now, there's many qurra. But the well known, the likes of Siddiq al-Manshawi, al-Husri, al-Hudayfi, what's his name? Ali Jabir, I believe, one of the qurra. Those who became very known, well known, and they would know qira'ah. Doesn't mean there's no other qurra and memorizes. Barakallahu feekum. So, Allahu Akbar, the ayat, the nubu'at in the Quran, the prophecies, akhbar al-ghayb, the knowledge of the unseen. How man that I lived in the middle of the desert was going to speak about Jannah in detail? Jahannam in details. Likewise about Allah's names and attributes, perfect names and attributes. About the Anbiya wal Rusul. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أَوَلَمْ يَكُلْ لَهُمْ آيَةً أَوَلَمْ يَكُلْ لَهُمْ آيَةً أَنْ يَعْلَمَهُ بَنُو إِسْرَائِيلِ. This sort of Shu'ara. The ayah before, I remember the ayah before it. نزل به الروح الأمين على قلبك لتكون من المنذرين بلسان عربي مبين. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, أَوَلَمْ يَكُلْ لَهُمْ آيَةً أَنْ يَعْلَمَهُ عُلَمَاءُ بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلِ أَنْ يَعْلَمَهُ عُلَمَاءُ بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلِ. الله أكبر. Is it not a sign for them that Ibn Israel knows what is in it is the truth? Abdullah ibn Salam, Sahabi al-Jaleel, and the other Jewish scholars or Israelite scholars accepted the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because they knew what Prophet ﷺ came with is the truth. And we'll finish with the, I'll skip two pages, okay? Because some of them already Sheikh spoke about. But I would highly recommend you, my brothers and sisters, go back and if you don't have this book, try to buy it online. Try bookshop, Salafi bookshop in Birmingham. Try to get it. Or other places, I'm not sure. Maybe in America, I'm not sure in America. Because this authentic statement is in America. The Shaykh Barakallahu Fikum is in summary, all that exists, all that occurs, all that is known, and everything in motion are proofs and clear evidences for the oneness of the nurturing Lord of the earth and the heavens, who originated the universe from nothing, who controls and disposes all affairs, who created the heavens and the earth, and has protected them by his power while holding them in their places, who created the human being from sperm only for him to become his clear, to become like proper human being, or adversary, his clear adversary, who causes death and life, caused happiness and misery, destroyed their transgressing nations with all sorts of punishment by way of example and saved the messengers and their followers. Certainly there are clear lessons and signs in all of that. Who created the sea and the peat and cleft the earth with rivers and springs? Isn't that from the effects of the one who merely says be and it is? So he's asking all these questions you have to ask yourself, or atheist. And even the Muslims, we ask ourselves these questions by reflecting and we say, خَلَقَهُنَّ الْعَزِيزَ الْحَكِيمِ. The one that created them is the Almighty, Al-Hakim, the All-Wise. Reflect. Don't let the scientists control your observation of the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because us knowing the asbab, the reasons for some things in the universe, does not negate that there is a creator who created the creation and its asbab and its effects, or its means. So is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the creator of everything, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even the Shaykh said, how amazing is it that there are souls that deny the Lord and the resurrection of the dead, how stray and blind. Conclusion, O Allah, we ask you by your beautiful names and lofty attributes to provide us with complete faith, true certainty, and to benefit us by your clear signs that are heard, your signs that are witnessed, your signs within the horizon, and your signs in ourselves. Certainly, there are clear evidences for those with certain faith. And the Shaykh, of course, goes on to make the dua, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept his dua. But Allah's tawfiq, we have finished the third book since we started the live stream. Well, I believe, because I did not finish it, and I just did some chapters from it. But alhamdulillah, we finished. By Allah's tawfiq, we finished al-usul iman, how to believe in the six pillars of iman. Likewise, we finished by Shaykh Uthaymeen, the first one. Alhamdulillah, we finished the how to believe what is the usul of al-sunnah wa jama'a by Shaykh al-Allam al-Walid, Salih al-Fawzan, may Allah preserve him. And we have today finished by Allah's tawfiq again, and his quwwa, wa la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah al-Ali al-Azim. We have finished with this kitab, or this risala, of الشيخ العلامة عبد الرحمن بن ناصر السعدي رحمه الله تعالى. And we ask God subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us ikhlas. And alhamdulillah, that's our way, my brothers and sisters. As I mentioned, miraran wa tikrara. Just let me double check if the live stream is, alhamdulillah, still working, hopefully. Because, yeah, alhamdulillah. نعم أيها الأحبة في الله. My brothers and sisters, may Allah bless you all. Just to remind you again, that's our way. Our way of the way of Ahlus-Sunnah Jama'ah. We do not just record videos of us debating and giving da'wah. No, likewise, we have to nurture and nurture the people and ourselves upon the Quran and the Sunnah and the books of Ahl-Ilm and the books of the Salaf and the books of Ahl-Ilm. Alhamdulillah, this is our way. Even when I go to Speaker's Corner, I used to open, I did even Speaker's Corner in the, our channel, the previous one, that it was not my channel, it was a brother channel. Sunni Dawah, I finished Nawaqid al-Islam in summary, and I finished, alhamdulillah, Thalath al-Usul in summary. I didn't finish, subhanAllah, I just mentioned the first part, which is to believe in Allah, to believe in the Messenger, and how to believe in Islam. Alhamdulillah, also the Qawaid Arba in Speaker's Corner, because alhamdulillah, my aim when I go there, when I go there to teach the people, not just for the sake of debating. And the reason I'm mentioning that, because a brother sent me a video or a clip of a brother who claimed to be Salafi, but recently has been exposed by cooperating with this Hizbi individual who's waging a war against Ahl-Sunnah, and how Allah exposed the people of deviations and misguidance, claiming something but clearly go against where they are preaching and claiming that they are upon the way of the Salaf. You can't be half-half, you know. I'm upon the way of the Salaf in Usul, but some also know how to just let it go. Let it slide. The Shaykh, barakallahu feekum, he was speaking about Speaker's Corner. He said, go back to scholars, we agree with that. And alhamdulillah, me myself, one of the Mashaykh told me to go to Speaker's Corner, and he said, give da'wah. And alhamdulillah. Secondly, then he goes and says, my opinion, Speaker's Corner. Akhi, opinion, man, anta. Maybe to your people you are something, but to us, we know you. Alhamdulillah. Khalas, may Allah guide us and guide you. Anyway, he starts saying, he said something which is true. He said, people are more focusing on debating. And it's true, I agree with that. Sahih. They're not raising the people correctly. And I have mentioned that many times. That's why when I speak, I always advise the brothers and sisters there. I said, listen, learn your deen. If you come and speak a corner for entertainment, then that's not from the deen. But as I've mentioned, there is khair in speaker's corner. Likewise, the people recording you and watching videos, and alhamdulillah, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَأَمَّا بِنِعْمَةِ رَبِّكَ فَحَدِّثْ. The blessings of your Lord, then narrate. Alhamdulillah, many people have contacted me, alhamdulillah, wallah, countless people contact us for our Instagram, Facebook, Sunni Dawah, do you ask Dawah, even Sunni Dawah before. That brother, I'm from, what they call it, I'm from Colombia, I'm from literally far away some countries, but I've been watching the videos and the debate, alhamdulillah, except Islam, after watching the videos. So the khayr, some people are looking at Speaker's Corner, but they're looking at the outcome of those videos. There's many, many, alhamdulillah. But again, yes, sometimes people, what they're doing, they're just focusing on watching debates. And that's not the way you learn your deen. Yes, as Sheikh Uthaymeen said about debating with the Christians, is good, because for the non-Muslim to see that we're not just claiming Islam is the truth. Your scholars that you're referring back to, the people that you trust, clearly they cannot answer the simple, the easy questions about your religion. So there is khair in it, and the place is worldwide now, and people from Australia, Japan, China. I never thought in my life that I would get contacted with someone from China to accept Islam. Because alhamdulillah, but Allah tawfiq awwalan wa akhiran, and then watch our videos. Alhamdulillah, but Allah tawfiq subhanahu wa ta'ala. So there's many, many people, akhi, I was Shi'i, I'm a Salafi. I had a Khawarij mentality, now alhamdulillah, I left it. Alhamdulillah, I have the proofs and the evidences. Alhamdulillah, clear cut. Alhamdulillah. So the point here is, I agree with the Prophet what he said about nurturing people with the correct way. That's what we do, alhamdulillah. When I go to Speaker's Corner, and it's true, some people go to Speaker's Corner, but I come to the masjid. That's why, alhamdulillah, when I go there, when it's time for my class, I will tell akhi, brothers, come. Even with advice sisters, listen, there's classes there, go. If they are, I would advise them to go to masajid who are known, not khayte bit the business, known for Salafiyya. Clear cut. You read the book of the Salaf, you see it in the real life. Not you read the book of the Salaf and you see it You don't see that. No. People I'm referring you to, you see, alhamdulillah, Salafiyya implemented that. The correct way, alhamdulillah. Are they perfect? They're not perfect. They make mistakes. We make mistakes too. Barakallahu feekum. So, inshallah ta'ala, tomorrow we start with Al-Qawa'id Al-Arba', the four principles of shirk by Imam Muhammad Al-Wahhab, again, for us to learn and to have usul and foundations. That's why when you have usul, foundations, then shubuhat will not affect you. But if someone just listened to this doubt, that doubt, who just always on social media, reading this quote, there, here and there, you're not going to learn this way. That's not how you learn. That's why when you read Kashf al-Shubuhat, Shaykh Muhammad al-Wahhab, rahimahu ta'ala, he mentioned, he said, there's two ways of responding to Shubuhat. One is a general way, okay? And one is detailed way. Shaykh Salih al-Sheikh, in his explanation, alhamdulillah, we finished Kashf al-Shubuhat in our masjid, alhamdulillah, and many books, alhamdulillah, but Allah still finished. He said, why? He said, because general refutation is easier for the layman to understand it. Detailed one, sometimes can be technical and hard to grasp it. So the general one, for example, like let us go back to the issue of khuruj. The general one that we know clearly, a hadith and the Salaf. The Salaf, when they wrote their books, from the aqidah they mentioned, to not rebel against the Muslim leaders. And we know that the books of the Mu'tazila and the Khawarij in Aqidah, they said to rebel against the Muslim leaders who are sinful. So any person who say, okay, the books of the Salaf said don't rebel, the books of the Mu'tazila say rebel. So if I say it's permissible to rebel, am I following the books of the Salaf or am I following the books of the Mu'tazila and the Khawarij? That's a simple way to understand it. That's why when Haji challenged him on Twitter, he responded to my video, but he responded to a video. He didn't even respond to my video. He responded to something that was in his head, not to my video. And I will respond to that video because it was, wallahi, I digress a bit, but Haji, I hope you heard this message. I always just think, why this guy is stubborn? When I watched the video that he responded to me, the last one, I believe it was the last one, because you always respond to me. Yeah? Because I know you like to respond. Yeah? Even if I make videos as just Haji, and you respond. And this is Allah al-Afu al-Abi. You're a child, brother. You have to calm down and respect yourself. Anyone that responds to you is a bootlicker, and he's quick to respond. MashaAllah. Okay? I'm not praising him saying, MashaAllah. I'm just being sarcastic, okay? Anyway, I'm going to respond. So what happened? I was thinking, why is this guy stubborn? Then I was reading the comment section. One guy praised him. So he pinned the praise. I said, okay, now I understand that. Clearly, Haji never responded to my video. Even though he put my video. He said, listen to Shamsi, what he's saying. Then, but wallah, he never responded to the video. And people praising him. I thought, oh, now I understand. That's why I a'udhu billah from the praise. Because it's dangerous. It can be deceiving you. You not responded to my speech, but people are praising you, think you responded. And the doubt is bringing, is not even a doubt. Because he's out of Sheikh Fawzan's book. Then I advise you to get Sheikh Fawzan's book, Explanation of Sharh Sunnah, Imam Barbahari. Then you will understand why Imam Barbahari mentioned trousers, Yamskin. Anyway, so this is how you refute doubt. Their principles, their general refutation. Then there's a detailed one. The shared barakallahu feekum. That learn, my brothers and sisters, study your deen. If you are able to travel to the scholars, my brothers, may Allah bless you, then do so. That's the best way. But if not, alhamdulillah, you can listen to scholars now. Like our masjid al-sunnah, alhamdulillah, we are dealing with Sheikh Zayd. We are dealing with our mashayikh, alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah, we learn from them. We benefit from them. Alhamdulillah. There's many like Sheikh Ubaid, our mashayikh. No, so Sheikh Ubaid never gave us. It was not live directly to us. It was to America and we joined in. The shared barakallahu feekum. Alhamdulillah, now you can learn. Sheikh is in Saudi or other countries, and you learn and you ask and you study. That's how you learn, my brothers and sisters. Don't watch too much debate. Just all your life, debate. You're going to benefit, but that's not how you become mu'assal. well grounded in ilm. Barakallahu feekum. That's my advice to you and to me and to you, may Allah bless you. We stop here, inshallah ta'ala, and we carry on tomorrow, inshallah ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us and to have mercy upon us and to, as Imam al-Albani used to say, this dua, which is a powerful dua. Allahumma khfir li ma la ya'lamun, waj'alni khairan mimma yadunnun, wa la tu'akhidni bima yaqulun. Used to say always Imam al-Albani, and who is Imam al-Albani? Asadus Sunnah, the true lion of a Sunnah, Imam al-Albani. I see some brothers calling some young people, like this advice to my brothers and sisters. Like one brother called me, I said, Akhi, you're the Asad of Islam. I'm not trying to humble myself. I am not, seriously. If I'm Asad of Islam, where is Albani then? If I'm the line of Islam, where is Bin Baz then? If I'm the line of Islam, where is Muqbil bin Hadi al-Wadi'i then? Where is Sheikh Rabi' then? Where is Sheikh Fawzan then? No, my brothers, we have to be careful. The problem that we go to extreme because we raise some people above their levels. No, brother. I'm not the lion of Islam. I'm not. I'm brother, miskeen. I love the deen. I love to defend the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala according to my ability. Alhamdulillah, that's what I am. And of course, I have mistakes. I have sins. May Allah forgive me. And I hide my mistakes and I hide my sins. And all of us. But the true lions of Islam are the Bin Baz, Ibn Uthaymeen, Muqbil, and other than them from the ulama of Sunnah. They are the true usud of Al-Sunnah Jama'ah. The true lines of Al-Islam. Barakallahu feekum. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Before, let me translate that dua. I forgot. So you should say, Allahumma khfir li ma la ya'lamun. And he took this dua from Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. Oh Allah, forgive me or forgive the sins which they don't know of, my sins which they don't know about. And waj'alni khayran mimma yadunnun, and make me better and ahsan, much better than what they think of me. Wala tu'akhidni bima yaqulun, and do not take me accountable because of that which they say about me. This Ibn al-Ba'ib, Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, you say that. Wama adraka man Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. And what makes you know who's Abu Bakr as-Siddiq? And Albani, you say that. And who's Imam Albani? In Manabir, even those who oppose him, those who oppose Imam Albani, they say what? وَحَسَّنَهُ الْأَلْبَانِي وَضَعَّفَهُ الْأَلْبَانِي وَصَحَّحَهُ الْأَلْبَانِي. Those who oppose him or those who follow him. Imam Albani, may Allah have mercy upon him. And may Allah have mercy upon those who have passed away from the Muslim Ummah. وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وسلم سليما كثيرا. بارك الله فيكم. جزاكم الله خيرا. بسم الله.